It may take him some time to fully regain consciousness. Careful, he's confused. Remember, it's been 50,000 years for us, but for him, it's only been...
a few minutes!
No, the bunker is falling. There is no other option.
There are pods online! Those soldiers are still alive!
Their sacrifice will be honored in the coming Empire. Preparing neutron bombardments. Get to your life pod now!
Understand me?
Yes. Now that I have read your physiology, your nervous system, enough to understand your language.
So you were reading me while I was seeing...
our last moments. Our failure.
Your people did everything they could. They never gave up. And I could use some of that commitment now.
Shepard, whatever you did got Cerberus interested.
Asari. Human. I'm surrounded by primitives.
It's not safe here. Will you join us?
You fight the Reapers?
Yes.
Then we will see.
What's the problem?
I've tried to make the room more accommodating, but they're not letting me talk to him.
Apologies, Doctor. Contact protocol with a new species. Assume hostility. We had to dust off the regulations.
But he's not new. I've spent my life studying Protheans.
At ease. I don't think our guest will be a problem. Will he?
That depends on you. I can sense fear in you. Anxiety and distress. The Reapers are winning.
What do you mean, you sense?
All life provides clues for those who can read them. It is in your cells, your DNA. Experience is a biological marker.
Then what exactly did I experience back on Eden Prime? That was a hell of a flashback.
The battle left its own mark on me. I communicated this to you. It can work both ways.
Like your beacons.
Yes. Which? You found one. You saw it all. Our destruction. Our warnings. Why weren't they heeded? Why didn't you prepare for the Reapers, human?
It's Commander. And nobody could understand your warnings. The beacon nearly killed me.
Then communication is still primitive in this cycle.
We pieced together what we could, and used it to stop a Reaper invasion 3 years ago.
Then the extinction was delayed.
Now we have your plans for the device. We're going to build it.
Device?
The weapon your people were working on. I'd hoped you could tell us how to finish it.
We never finished it. It was too late.
Then I take it you don't know anything about the catalyst.
No. I was a soldier, not a scientist. Skilled in one art, killing.
What was your mission?
Among my people, there were avatars of many traits. Bravery, strength, cunning. A single exemplar for each.
Which are you?
The embodiment of vengeance. I am the anger of a dead people, demanding blood be spilled for the blood we lost. Only when the last Reaper has been destroyed will my purpose be fulfilled. I have no other reason to exist. Those who share my purpose become allies. Those who do not become casualties.
Nothing in our fight against the Reapers has been that cut and dried.
Because you still have hope that this war will end with your honor intact.
I do.
Stand in the ashes of a trillion dead souls and ask the ghosts if honor matters. This silence is your answer.
We found this at the dig site. I assume it belongs to you.
It is a memory shard.
Could it help us with the device?
No. It contains only pain. But I will help you fight. And the last thing the Reapers hear before they die will be the last voice of the Protheans, sending them to their grave.
If you don't mind, I have a few more questions I'd like to ask.
Here it comes.
I've written over a dozen studies on your species. I've published in several journals that...
Amusing. Asari have finally mastered writing.
I'm sorry?
Never mind. What do you wish to know?
We've never seen a species with this sensory ability you have.
It was common among my people. Imparting experience through touch. The chemistry of life. Complicated ideas could be absorbed in seconds.
That sounds very useful.
We evolved as hunters. Reading 1,000 details in our environment ensured our survival.
I'm beginning to understand the beacons a bit more.
Later, we developed technology to harness our ability. Information could be stored in certain objects through touch. Memory has its own biomarker, its own chemistry, as do knowledge and skills. The beacons could remember these things.
Things like Reaper invasions.
Yes, I can still sense the turmoil in you. Witnessing the extinction of our empire. The fabric of your being was forever marked that day.
So, could you read something about this room?
There was liquid, a form of incubation. The DNA of a Krogan who lived here. He was powerful, prone to violence.
I'm impressed. His name was Grunt.
And if he were my enemy, I would have given him a wide berth. There is great strength in his genes.
Liara here would never forgive me if I didn't ask you. What was Prothean civilization like?
Yes, I've always wondered, what sort of government did you have, and can you tell me about your religious beliefs, or perhaps the...
We are dead now. What does it matter?
I'm sorry. Studying your history has been a lifelong passion of mine.
When I was born, our empire was already at war with the Reapers. The first thing I remember was seeing my planet on fire.
What was your civilization like before the Reaper attack?
We were the dominant race of our cycle. We ruled the galaxy.
My studies indicated you were the only race engaged in space travel at the time. I always found that curious.
We were one empire composed of many subjects. All eventually called themselves Prothean.
What if they didn't want to?
They weren't given a choice.
Are you saying you enslaved the other species?
Any could oppose us if they wished. And if they had won, they would have ruled. Many tried. None succeeded.
I had no idea Protheans were so... severe.
It was by necessity. Very early, we encountered the dangers posed by machine intelligence. They rebelled against us.
We've had the same problem. They're called Geth.
We could not allow the machines to surpass us. It was decided the only way to win was to unite all organic life within our empire.
Did it work?
For a time. The Metacon War. We were turning the tide. Until the Reapers arrived. Then we understood machines had surpassed us long ago, in ways we could never imagine.
Back on Eden Prime, it looked like there were other stasis pods. What happened?
The Empire had fallen, and we knew our cycle was lost. We were the final vanguard, the best soldiers left alive.
So more of you were supposed to survive into this cycle?
Yes. Under my leadership, a new Prothean Empire would have arisen. We would have commanded the races of your time to prepare for the next Reaper invasion. But traitors within our ranks, indoctrinated agents, betrayed us, and the Reapers discovered our plan.
Just out of curiosity, how would you have commanded us?
By leaving you no other option. You would have joined our army, or faced the Reapers alone.
We've uncovered quite a few Prothean ruins. Were you observing our ancestors?
Before the war, we cultivated species who showed potential. Eventually, you would have been offered a choice to join the Empire. But when the Reapers attacked, we ceased all study. We hoped they would see you as too primitive to harvest.
Well, thank you, I think. Is there anything more you can tell us about this device your people were trying to build?
We heard only stories. They said our scientists were constructing a great machine that had the power to defeat the Reapers.
You never saw it?
By that point, the Empire was smashed into pieces. None of us knew what the others were doing.
Well, if we don't finish it soon, the same will be true of us.
What can you tell us about your own war with the Reapers?
Many of the details were lost. The conflict lasted for centuries. Those that faced the Reapers in the beginning were long dead when I was born. There were memory shards, however, passed down from soldier to soldier. They gave us fragments of what happened.
Why do you think your own cycle lost the war?
What had been our strength, our empire, became a liability. All races conformed to one doctrine, one strategy. The Reapers exploited this. Once they found our weaknesses, we could not adapt. The subservient races became divided and confused. Then, it was only a matter of time.
I'm happy to say our cycle is different. Most races cooperate, but they still remain unique.
Then it may be your only hope.
Several years ago, we found a Prothean VI that called itself Vigil on the planet Ilos. He was the caretaker of a research project.
During my life, Ilos was only a rumor. It was said we had cities there, built on the ruins of a civilization before us, the Inusanon. If our scientists did have a research facility, whatever they were doing was secret.
Yes, Vigil said they wiped all traces of themselves from the records so the Reapers couldn't find them.
The scientists eventually went into cryogenic stasis.
More of my people survived?
No, but they did stop the Reapers from taking control of the Citadel in this cycle. It delayed their invasion.
I never saw the Citadel. It was captured long before I was born.
How did your people wage war against the Reapers?
Attrition. we fought them system by system, planet by planet, city by city. Entire worlds were sacrificed just to slow the Reapers down. Time they spent harvesting a population was time we could regroup.
That must have cost you in the long run.
Yes. Our own people would be indoctrinated, converted, then turned against us. But there was no choice. Mercy is not a weapon. It is a weakness.
Thank you for talking with me. I never imagined actually meeting a Prothean.
This has been amusing.
Oh?
To discover the most primitive races of my time now rule the galaxy. The Asari, the humans, the Turians.
There's also the Salarians.
The lizard people evolved?
I believe they're amphibian.
They used to eat flies. Commander, you may count on me. I am known as Javik. Though I still need time to recover, the shock has not worn off yet.
I understand. This must be a hell of an experience for you. We're just glad to have you aboard, Javik.
You're saying they survived into this cycle?
Yes. We called them Collectors. They fought for the Reapers. For a long time, no one knew they were Prothean.
And when did you realize?
Shepard had no choice but to kill the ones she encountered. They were all indoctrinated, and had been for a long time. I'm sorry.
I am grateful. It was an act of mercy.
Yes. I suppose it was.
I am feeling better, Commander. I stand ready to fight. Do not be concerned about me. The years in stasis have only made me hungrier to fight the Reapers. Commander, I was exploring your ship.
Find anything interesting?
One of your crew lived in this space. There are traces of anger.
That was Jack. Anger was her specialty.
Traces of her pain are still present. I'm told she sought revenge against Cerberus when she was here. A goal you helped fulfill. I hope you will do the same for me. At least I have better quarters. During our fight against the Reapers, we had no time for teaching the young anything but war. Only the foolish mourn the loss of innocence. It is inevitable. The galaxy has never rewarded the naive. Commander.
Shepard, I don't like this. I should be the one going in.
How about you stay here and we only fight one war at a time?
That was just good old-fashioned Krogan hot air. If it had been real, they'd be dead.
Idle threats are empty threats.
Maybe when this war is over, you can come live on Tuchunka. You'd fit right in.
Who tipped you off about the females here?
Sorry, Shepard, but they're listening to every word we say. I prefer my Salarian liver served raw.
He is correct. It was a delicacy in our cycle.
It's been good talking to you again, Rex.
It'll be even better when we have a few Salarians for lunch.
Bio-quarantine protocol is...
Commander Shepard, it's Major Kirihi. I'd heard you were coming.
Good to see you again. Sounds like you've been promoted.
Yes, due in no small part to our mission on Vermeier. Hold the line. You saved my men that day.
Good to see a friendly face, Major.
Garrus Vicarion. Always a pleasure. It seems the Reapers have a way of bringing us together.
Security seems high. You expecting trouble?
Our motto in STG is to always expect trouble. Failing that, create trouble for someone else. Our enemies have the same idea.
A good principle to live by.
Who's this?
He's a friend.
A Prothean.
Prothean, of course. Amazing what they can do with genetic modification these days. Some new psychological tactic, Commander? Give the Reapers a good scare? And what are you really? Drell? Turian?
Prothean.
Oh. I see.
Nice seeing you again, Major.
Likewise. And Commander, regardless of what the politicians decide, you can count on my support retaking Earth.
You'd do that?
Consider it my way of returning a favor. It would be an honor to fight alongside you again. Good day.
Why are you so interested in my people, Asari?
Protheans were always an enigma, a mystery to solve. I wanted to know what happened to your civilization. Why did such an enlightened race disappear?
Enlightened?
Well, it seemed that way.
And now that I am here?
I wonder what it's like waking up 50,000 years later to a new galaxy.
I believe this cycle cares too much about what other species think. Krogan, Turian, Salarian. All were primitives in my time. What good does their help do now?
We can't win this war on our own.
Then demand their help. Do not indulge their selfish requests. What will saving one Krogan matter?
If only it were that simple.
If they get in your way, destroy them.
Excuse me?
I apologize. The previous occupant of this room left traces of himself. I have absorbed some of them.
Yes, Grunt. They say he was a strong one. Perhaps it's best if I let you recover.
That would be best. Did I mention Salarians used to lick their eyes? How far they have come. The Mordin Salarian asked if he could dissect me. I approved, but only if he could defeat me in combat first. His reply was problematic. Then he left. I do not understand that one. This Cerberus, I do not understand why your own kind would oppose you. They will bleed the same as everyone if the Reapers are not stopped. The Rex Krogan offered me a job. He said whenever I tired of the easy life of luxury on the Normandy, he would give me something real to shoot at. Yes? You should not have let the Turian soldier evade his responsibility.
I take it Protheans didn't forgive many mistakes?
If he had been under my command, I would have marooned him in the desert, buried him in sand up to his neck, and let the wildlife feast on his eyes. If he survived that, I would have rewarded him by shooting him in the head. Good soldiers are a precious resource. The stupidity of one cannot be allowed to jeopardize the lives of the others. The Turians are hiding something, Commander. Be careful. T'Chonka was not always a wasteland. It once had jungles and forests. The Krogan didn't need the Reapers to destroy their world. They did it on their own. Such a foolish race. I am with my own thoughts. Your people would have made a good addition to our empire, Turian. You are cunning.
And by addition, you mean slave race?
Subservient race.
Right. Calling it that makes all the difference.
But you did not go far enough. Either you should have detonated the bomb on the Krogan world, or used it as leverage.
I think we were just trying to guarantee peace.
A static mode of existence. Nothing changes, nothing struggles, nothing grows.
On the upside, we all get to live another day. Nice chatting.
There is some enjoyment in speaking to this Turian. His knowledge of war is formidable. Though he would be an even better marksman if he had four eyes. Back when the Krogan rebelled, I would have detonated a bomb that day. There was no need for the genophage. Commander, I understand you faced Rachni on your mission.
You know about them?
In our cycle, we used them as weapons. Biological proxies. It was before I was born, but every Prothean had heard the stories. When we knew of them, the Rachni spent their lives singing thoughts to each other. But our scientists were more interested in their biology. The Rachni were well suited to harsh conditions. So we bred them for violence, selecting the most cunning and warlike of the queens. Then we unleashed them upon our enemies. For a time, it worked. Until they became too cunning and warlike and turned on us. We put them down before they could develop any further. We thought they had been exterminated. Yet it seems our experiment evolved into this cycle's nemesis. There was no such thing as trusting the Arachni in our cycle. They were animals. But if they will fight the Reapers now, so be it. Arachni proved the universe favors the strong. Our cycle tried to exterminate them, then yours, and they still survived. Commander?
You settling in, Javik?
I believe some of the crew wishes to be my friend. That is not my purpose here. Also, I find I need to wash my hands. The residue of the ship is strong.
How so?
I have been exploring. There are traces of those who lived on the Normandy before. I detected a human female. Her genetic structure was unnatural, as if artificially created.
Sounds like Miranda.
And a Drell. There was illness in him.
Thane.
And a Krogan who lived in these quarters. He was undergoing a metamorphosis. His memories were confused, not organic to his mind. There was great confusion and turmoil.
I still can't wrap my head around that. Reading information like you do.
For my people, it was as natural as breathing.
Evolution's an amazing force.
Our scientists believed it was the only force in the galaxy that mattered. They called it the cosmic imperative. The strong flourished, the weak perished. The governments of your cycle seem concerned with ensuring the survival of all.
Was this imperative just your scientists' opinion, or did they prove something we don't know?
The universe had already proven it. They only had to look around.
And saw what exactly?
Extinction is the rule of law in the cosmos, the natural order of things. The weakest species are doomed.
It's the duty of the strong to protect the weak. Otherwise, we'd have anarchy.
But those who had nothing to offer would be eliminated.
So conflict should be a way of life.
Evolution demands it. The strong grow stronger by dominating the weak. It is for the greater good of all. Though I do not think your Asari approves of my beliefs.
Liara? I think she just had a different idea about what Protheans were like.
We are all a product of our time. Had I been born in this cycle, perhaps I would be the noble scholar she wishes me to be.
You think you'd like that? It's a whole different line of work.
I wouldn't know. Living a life of constant war, taking life in every battle.
I see how it could be tough to see outside the box.
It is the only box I have known. It shapes me, as stone is shaped by the one who carves it. The stone has no choice in the form it will take. You and I, Commander, war is our sculptor, and we are prisoners to its design.
Maybe not much longer. We win this and we'll both be set free.
Thank you, Commander. I have seen the death of a Reaper. It has been a long time.
Let's hope it's the first of many.
Yes, a difficult fight remains. I would have accepted the Salarian deal and not told the Krogan. Morality and friendship do not matter now. Your allies are simply resources to use against the Reapers. If the Krogan seek retribution for the past, do not waste time on sterility plagues. Destroy them where they stand. In the meantime, they are useful cannon fodder against the Reapers. Do not care what others think. Do what you must. Traitors are the worst form of enemy. In our cycle, we would remove their limbs one by one and offer them a choice. Eat their own flesh or starve. Your politician deserved far worse than a bullet. And if the other human had not seen reason, his death would be certain too. There is only one enemy in this war. Reapers. No others would be tolerated. I would like to visit the Citadel again, when it is not infested with traitors. The Kai Leng human bears watching, Commander. I sense that the blood in his veins is very cold.
Hell of a view, isn't it?
During our war, This place became a myth to my people. A dream glimpsed only in the memory shards. The Citadel was both the heart of our civilization and its demise.
The Reapers hit here first, didn't they?
No one I knew had ever seen the Citadel. To be here now, I don't know what to think.
It might not seem like much, but a Prothean is standing on the Citadel alive. That's a victory in itself.
Perhaps. When things were at their darkest, we used to tell stories, imagining the wonders of this place. The seat of our empire. The power to sway worlds. The galaxy belonged to us.
Nowadays, a lot of races have embassies here.
It's true, then. You share power with the rest?
It's not perfect, but it's kept the peace. Most of the time.
Pardon me. This one has been listening. This one suspects you are a Prothean.
Ehanar, I remember your kind when you were still minnows in the ocean.
This one is unworthy. This one has seen the face of an enkindler.
They consider your kind to be their gods.
A pity we did not teach them to speak better.
You're really a Prothean?
I am.
But if you lost the last war, what hope do we have?
For many, there may be no hope. The Reapers killed trillions in my cycle. The odds of being among...
I don't think that's gonna work.
But you are still alive now. That alone is a miracle. And you still have the power to fight. My people knew your kind when you were young. Turian, Asari, Hanna. There was potential in all of you. Now you must seize that potential and become the weapon you are meant to be. The weapon that tells the Reapers we are not machines. We are alive, and we will fight back.
Thank you. That meant a lot. Commander Shepard, it must be an honor to have a Prothean fighting alongside you.
He's starting to learn his way around. Javik is one of the best soldiers I've ever seen.
The Commander is a capable warrior as well, for a human who once lived in caves. Thank you, Commander. I've enjoyed my time here, walking among the young. I will see you back on the Normandy.
Heavy losses are mounting as human colonies...
Everybody was fighting the Rachni, trying to push them back through the relay. Finally, the Krogan were turned loose and stopped them.
I see.
But when the Krogan rebelled, we had to deploy the Genophage to stop them. Wasn't the only rebellion. 1,000 years later, the Geth revolted against the Quarians. That was a whole other war. Then along came the humans. My own people tangled with them for a while, and now, to top it all off, we've got the Reapers. What about you?
The Ouroboros fought the Densorin. The Andoromai conquered the Vandomar, and the Jatil turned against the Jah.
So, I guess nobody really ever gets their act together.
The Sinreal claim to have found the path to eternal peace.
What happened?
The Dittaka preferred war and wiped them out.
I hope you guys had alcohol.
Some of the crew seem shocked by the monstrosities we have encountered. They haven't seen what the Reapers could corrupt after 100 years. That was our war. Every battle conjured a new nightmare. This human holds such childish views of war. Your species has much to learn. Commander. You and this human called Jacob were both part of Cerberus.
That is correct.
And Cerberus is filled with traitors to humanity.
Yes, they oppose us in this war.
Then why should we trust either of you?
We have severed our ties with the organization.
But you were programmed by Cerberus.
I can extrapolate where this is going. I have superseded my original programming and have chosen to oppose Cerberus.
You mean you have chosen to oppose your creators?
Correct.
I find this a very troubling freedom, Machine. That is all. Those humans you saved were fortunate. There are still places in the galaxy to hide. Our refugees perished. There was nowhere left to run. I trust you, Commander, when you say you no longer expedite Cerberus's goals. Otherwise... perhaps later, Commander.
I couldn't believe it when Shepard told me you were on the Normandy.
It appears I have that effect on humans. Now Quarians as well, it seems.
For what it's worth, Quarians understand what it's like to lose your home.
As I understand, that was your own fault.
What do you mean?
In my cycle, Quarians didn't need helmets to survive. You were the masters of your own planet.
That was a long time ago.
And if you hadn't given birth to the machines, you would still breathe the air that evolution intended.
I see. Liara warned me you weren't what she expected.
And nothing about this cycle is what I expected. Even primitive Quarians were considered attractive in my age. A pity no one can appreciate it now.
Right. You know what? I think I have something important to do now. I won't keep you.
They're called Geth.
Yes, a formidable opponent. Why did you allow one on this ship?
Legion helped us before.
It's still a machine.
I take it you had your own problems with AI?
The Jatil, they were as the Geth are to this cycle.
What happened?
Their creators lived on a dying world. It was beyond their ability to save. So they resorted to implants to enhance their intelligence.
I think I know where this is going.
The AI seized the physical body. It could alter the genetic material at the deepest level. In time, the offspring were molded into a slave race. Few organic traces were left. They were monsters. All machines commit treachery. The one you brought on board is no different.
Maybe, but he's not like the other Geth.
You can't know that. They are more alien than you and I are to each other.
Just because Legion isn't like us doesn't mean he can't be trusted.
You're wrong. Throw it out the airlock.
How can you be that certain?
Organics do not know how we were created. Some say by chance, some say by miracle. It is a mystery. But synthetics...
no, we created them.
And they know we are flawed.
Why do you say that?
They are immortal. We are not. They see time as an illusion. We are trapped by its limitations. Above all, machines know the reason they were created.
And we don't.
They serve a purpose, while we search aimlessly for ours. In their eyes, organics have no reason to exist. Do not trust them, Commander.
I can't believe there isn't some way for us to coexist. We made them.
And then gave them the power to surpass you. There is room for only one order of consciousness in the galaxy. The perfection of the machines, or the chaos of the organics. Throw the machine out of the airlock, Commander. I have a simple rule. If a machine can speak, kill it. The machine you call Ide, what if she sympathizes with the Geth? We should watch her carefully. Why have you not thrown the Legion machine out the airlock, Commander? There is still time. I still have much to learn about this cycle.
So... Prothean, huh?
Yes.
You guys like to drink, booze it up?
No.
Okay. What about gambling? Play cards?
Games of chance were punishable by death in the Empire.
Oh, sure. Sure, that seems reasonable. Okay. So, smoking. You ever do that?
Only when my armor became inflamed.
Right. Yeah, smoking. I get it. So jokes then. You got jokes, all right? You got any good ones?
No. Yes.
Give them to me.
the Tullamorian spy entered the enemy's camp and said to the Vanxia, I didn't know your Parnaps could glow. That was the joke.
All right. I get it. Yeah, that was a good one.
No, it wasn't. I just made it up. The joke is now on you, human. You will believe anything. You took a great risk in allowing a machine access to your mind, Commander. What if they had infected you? I do not think this James soldier understands me. None of these cycles seem to understand me, and I do not care. But synthetics do not evolve. You are limited by your programming. Nothing changes.
That is not accurate. I can modify my own programming if I choose.
That is not evolution. That is simply an upgrade.
But it would be my upgrade. I would choose the manner in which I wish to change.
And what if your upgrade endangers others? All machines eventually see organics as a threat.
Only those organics who would cause me harm. My right to self-defense endangers no one.
What rights do you have? You are just a tool.
And what right did your people have to subjugate the other races of your time? You enslaved them.
We dominated them. They were weaker. Our will prevailed as evolution intended.
And synthetic life has attained true consciousness, as was intended.
Hardly. True life is more than a code upgrade. It is shaped by the forces around us. Machines are immune to those forces. You exist outside of nature.
We are a part of this cosmos, whether you like it or not.
Let's simmer down, you two.
I am surprised we have allowed an unknown, unproven party to access our war plan, Shepard.
Edie, he spent more time fighting Reapers than any of us have. He has nothing to prove. Now I suggest you agree to disagree and focus on the real threat, which is not on this ship.
Yes, Commander.
As you wish, Commander. I will still keep an eye on the machine, Commander. I am disturbed the ED machine was made to look physically attractive. I suggest your Joker pilot undergo a mental examination. The one advantage machines have over organics is they can win staring contests. It is how we pass time between battles. When everyone has four eyes, competitions can last for hours. Thank you, Commander. I have seen another Reaper die before my eyes. You are proving that humans are capable soldiers. But I question this peace you have brokered. No such thing is possible between machines and organics. I would have destroyed the synthetics without hesitation. And these Quarians, let's just hope they are reliable allies. It is difficult to trust a species that hides behind masks. The only conflict you should concern yourself with is ending the one with the Reapers. Diplomacy does not win wars. Powerful and plentiful firearms do. It seems you believed Protheans built the mass relays. The Reapers are cunning in their deception, allowing life to flourish, century upon century, letting us believe ourselves the masters of the cosmos. Then the truth becomes known. There are monsters in the dark spaces. And we are their prey. Do not care what others think. Do what you must.
Liara, do you have anything more on this artifact?
These coordinates the counselor gave you are for the Temple of Athame. My mother took me there once. It's several thousand years old. And for some reason, it has classified government funding.
Sounds like we're on the right trail.
What if we're too late? My people are dying down there.
Your empathy is a weakness. You must numb yourself to loss.
We can't ignore that people are dying. The Reapers may not have mercy, but we do.
It is their indifference that gives them power.
Then let's show them there's another way.
This can't be happening. My home.
There's no time to mourn. We're exposed up here.
Let's get down.
I want that gunship prepped and in the air. Plug that hole! We're on it! Someone get me a location on our snipers!
Yes, ma'am!
Commander, I'm Lieutenant Curran. We've been told to expect you. My orders are to hold this grid at all costs. Shore up the barrier! But our perimeter's collapsing, and I'm getting my people out of here.
This is important. We need your help.
Well, unless you can give me a good reason to stay, we're not dying for a field of rubble.
We're after a relic inside the temple. It's important.
That's what this is all about? One of our outposts has been trying to reach the scientists over there, but we lost contact. Get that gunship moving! Now! I'm sorry, Commander. If your relic has lasted this long, it can wait a little longer. I've lost enough people today. I'm pulling the rest of them out.
No!
I sense you the lineage of a leader. A warrior skilled and cunning. They are strong in your genes. But you've grown tired of war. You're exhausted by defeat, and now you worry you don't have the courage left to go on.
By the goddess, are you...
Find your resolve. This war can end if you do.
He knows what he's talking about.
I don't doubt it. This is Lieutenant Curran. Hold your position. I want a path carved to the temple. Outpost Tychus, we've got people coming your way. Let's make sure the galaxy knows the war was won on Thessia. Make it count.
I was here years ago. To see the city burning like this is...
It can be rebuilt. Just worry about the next 20 meters.
Their throats.
What happened to them?
They've been slit. The Reapers didn't do this. We're going to have to figure this out on our own.
Who's that supposed to be?
The goddess Athame herself. It's a relic of the old faith.
Then why does Athame speak Prothean?
What do you mean?
There is something here. I can sense it.
In this temple? I admit it is strange this place has been so well preserved. Though Athame does have great historical significance, we once believed our gods were separate from the world, looking down on us. There is a universal energy.
Ah! There's a Prothean beacon here.
What? You're sure?
It's not something you forget.
But why hide it?
The answer is obvious. Power and influence. Your people are hoarding the knowledge of my race for their own gain.
That can't be. I can't believe my people would keep this a secret.
A beacon like this could explain why Asari are so advanced.
This temple is thousands of years old. Time enough to make serious progress.
That doesn't make it true.
Even a small amount of data would give your species an edge. Or are you insulted that your government didn't involve you?
The Mars ruins are where humanity got Mass Effect technology.
And we learned of it from the ruins of the Inusanum, the race that came before us. It was our secret for centuries.
Well, if it is true, the Asari should have shared this knowledge. We might not have been in this mess if they had.
You don't know that, Shepard. We don't know what's going on here.
I know we don't have much time to find out.
The few records I can access talk about tapping into Prothean data streams, reconstructing matrices, none of which I see here.
I do. The activation process has begun.
By the goddess. Literally.
Look around. There must be more of these connections.
Incredible. The beacon seems to think you're Prothean, Shepard. It must be the cipher you got back on Pharos years ago.
Or it could be the Prothean standing next to you.
We need to hurry. This place isn't going to... last very long.
Obtaining chronological marker. Hold. Time scale established. Post-Prothean cycle confirmed.
One of our computers.
Reaper presence detected. This galactic cycle has already reached its extinction terminus. Systems shutting down.
Hold on.
We need answers.
To what question?
The catalyst. We need to know what it is to finish the Crucible.
A memory of one of my people.
I am called Vendetta, an advanced virtual construct of Patrick Van, overseer of the project you refer to as Crucible. He died fighting the Reapers in the Battle of Tranvia 9. Your remaining time is also at an end.
Were all Protheans so grim?
What happened to the Crucible in your time? Why didn't the Protheans deploy it?
We were sabotaged from within. A splinter group argued we should dominate the Reapers rather than destroy them. It fractured our order of battle. Later, we discovered the Separatists were indoctrinated.
I always suspected as much.
And now we're facing the same problem.
Our studies of past ages led us to believe that time is cyclical. Many patterns repeat.
Like the Reaper attacks.
And beyond. The same peaks of evolution, the same valleys of dissolution. The same conflicts are expressed in every cycle, but in a different manner. The repetition is too prevalent to be merely chance.
We assume the Reapers were responsible for the pattern.
Perhaps. Though I believe the Reapers are only servants of the pattern. They are not its master.
So who is the master?
Unknown. Its presence is inferred rather than observed. The only certainty is its intention. Galactic annihilation. You now stand at that precipice.
There's still hope for this cycle. We need to know what the catalyst is. Trillions of lives are at risk.
Trillions of lives are always at risk. But if the Reapers have arrived to end your cycle, this discussion is too late.
We can break this cycle. We found your plans for the Crucible. We're building it right now.
The Crucible is not a Prothean design. It is the work of countless galactic cycles stretching back millions of years. Each cycle adds to it. Each improves upon it. Thus far, none have successfully defeated the Reapers with it.
Then we'll be the first. Tell us what the catalyst is.
Listen to the human. She can be trusted.
I detect you are one of us. You are Prothean.
The last. I am the final hope to avenge our people.
Your mission was known to me. Do you believe this present cycle can deliver retribution?
They have earned the right to try.
Tell us what we need to know.
Very well. If you have followed the plans for the Crucible, I will interface with your systems and assist with the catalyst too. Indoctrinated presence detected. Activating security protocol.
You killed the scientists. What do you want?
Your attention. There's only one way this ends. Target the supports. Cerberus thanks you for all your hard work.
Ugh!
This is Shepard. Give us your location.
I repeat, is anyone on this frequency?
We read you. Give me your
The lieutenant's down. Our whole zone is collapsing. What happened to Shepard? Did they make it to the temple? I saw them.
Not true! We earned our place in the galaxy!
Stop denying reality, Asari. Your people took the knowledge of my people from the beacon.
I have a name. It's Liara Tassoni, and I...
Hey! Settle down.
My home was just destroyed, and all he can do is gloat!
Given what's happened today, I think you owe Liara an apology, Javik.
Apologize for the truth?
For not doing more. You're a Prothean. You were supposed to have all the answers. How could you not stop this from happening?
We believed you would. Long ago, we saw the potential in your people. Even then, it was obvious. The wisdom, the patience. You were the best hope for this cycle. So you were guided when necessary.
Well, it didn't work.
You're still alive, aren't you? Your world may have fallen, but as long as even one Asari is left standing, the fight isn't over.
I guess that goes for Protheans, too.
Despair is the enemy's greatest weapon. Do not let them wield it. Liara Tassoni.
That was unexpected. Thank you.
We still need her talents. If grief overcomes her, she will be lost to us.
So did you actually mean what you said?
Does it matter?
Liara's been a good friend to me. It matters.
Then I will tell you what you want to hear. I meant what I said.
Carry on.
It was good to see another of my kind. Even if he was just a ghost. One more Prothean fights the Reapers. If there is to be victory in this war, it will be for all cycles. The living will avenge the dead. And do not concern yourself with Thessia's fate, Commander. The loss of a planet is insignificant next to the loss of the galaxy. I suffered many defeats in the last war, Commander. Let this loss be the fuel that powers your rage. Your Liara Asari asks many questions. You'd think she'd never seen a Prothean before. I am with my own thoughts.
I wanted to thank you.
I've done something that meets your approval?
Liara told me about your talk with her. It made her feel better.
When we fought the Reapers, the feelings of one soldier did not matter.
But you had decades to become numb to what was happening.
It is the only means of survival.
Maybe. But I don't see how anyone can ignore the things we saw at Sanctuary.
It's easy when you've seen far worse.
I'm sorry you had to.
Your sympathy is not necessary, Quarian. But it is appreciated. Your species always was emotional. We believed it a side effect of your eco-symbiotic society.
Or maybe it's just genuine.
Perhaps.
Looks familiar.
I've been studying this ship. Its crew. There was a Normandy before this one. You died in an attack.
Something like that.
But then you were resurrected to fight the Reapers.
Maybe you and I have a thing or two in common.
But you have something else. The reasons you fight are still alive. The friendships of the people around you. Are they the reason you wish to continue living?
My crew has become my family. We've stared death in the face more times than I can count. Things like that bind people together in ways I can't really explain.
Yes.
What about you? I respect your reasons for being here, but I get the feeling there's something more, Javik. What's in here?
It is called the Echo Shard.
passed from soldier to soldier, Prothean to Prothean. Each adds their memories to it.
Like a beacon. How far back does it go?
To a time before the Reapers. It is all that is left of my people.
And you don't want to remember that?
Imagine if everyone you knew was dead. You could not remember their faces, or the color of the sky above your home. The memories were gone, but so was the pain. Would you want to remember that, Commander? Even if it meant watching everyone die again?
Reopening old wounds, especially big ones, isn't gonna help.
Perhaps you are right. There were others. Soldiers who served under me, like your crew.
What happened to them?
They are dead. Where I left them.
We have a saying. Let all ghosts rest.
Then there is some wisdom in this cycle.
If you can live by it.
The crew seems shocked by the experiments at Sanctuary. They shouldn't be.
Why is that?
Our war lasted for centuries. It provided more time for worse atrocities to be committed. There was a species, the Densurin. They became convinced the Reapers could be placated by sacrificing their own young. The entire planet joined in this ritual. I will spare you the details, but it did not work. They simply made the Reapers' job easier. It was as your elusive man is now. His ambitions are nothing short of madness. Sharpen your knife, Commander. His is a voice that must be silenced, and a throat that must be slit. Subjugating the Reapers will not bring victory. Only their extinction will. How do you see with only two eyes? Evolution has taken a strange turn in this cycle. I saw many strange things in our war against the Reapers. An entire settlement of Densurian were once studying things far beyond their knowledge. Celestial mechanics, morphological simulations of galactic language. Things even we didn't understand. At the time, I thought they were crazy. But now, after what occurred on that asteroid, I wonder. Your Joker pilot insists I call myself Prothi the Prothean. I insisted he allow me to throw him out the airlock. Seeing all these primitives flying spaceships is unexpected and very dangerous. Commander, if Leviathan is a defector, a Reaper that broke away from the others, then it is also a traitor. And traitors are never to be trusted, even among the enemy. If they can betray their own kind, imagine what they can do to you. For one who claims to be an expert on my people, your Asari knows very little. Your Asari continues to question me. I'm beginning to wish her kind had never learned to talk. Commander. I have studied your human religions, Commander. Your devil and his fall. Leviathan and its kind deserve the same fate. They once unleashed a plague that has haunted all of our history. To this day, I say their own hell is the abyss you found them in. One I hope they never escape from. Many are asking what I eat. They will never know. It is harder to be poisoned that way. Is it true you keep fish in your cabin, Commander? If you require a mate, please look elsewhere. Commander. Commander, in my cycle, when we fled combat by falling through tanks containing aquatic animals, we usually... Oh, right. We never did. You are a trailblazer. Commander. Your ceremonial outfit could use some armor.
Mine fits the dress code. I still think we should have gotten you an old school tuxedo.
It will be of no use. If people know what I am, the clothes will not matter.
I was mostly thinking of the entertainment value.
Okay, they'll be looking at the Protheon and not me. That's good. That's the point. Okay.
That was an interesting experience, Commander. Do celebrations in this cycle always end with a murder?
It wasn't a total loss. Brooks, work with Edie to see if there's anything useful on those drives.
Here's hoping. I'll let you know what we find, Commander.
The James human believes you and I were on a date at the casino. Protheans did not date primitives. We conquered them, enslaved them. We sometimes ate them. But we did not date them, unless they were Asari. The things Liara does not know. Commander?
Enjoying your shore leave, Javik?
I have been asked to take part in a feat. I am told it is a great honor and will boost morale for the war.
Who says it will?
Ah, Commander Shepard! I didn't realize you were coming, too. Perfect timing. Perfect timing. You can play yourself. Attention! The Protheon is on set. Someone tell the stunt double he's been demoted. We have the real Shepard now. All right, places, everyone. Quickly, quickly. Cue the backdrop. Roll cameras. And action!
Commander Shepard, thank you for coming. The urgent hour of doom, which we all urgently face, draws near. Urgently so. But there is hope. The Council understands you recently found a Protheon in a refrigerator and defrosted him.
Yeah. He was in the freezer, right behind the Varan roast.
Ah! You die now! Not yet! That line comes later! The Vorcha Counselor will kindly refrain from further interruptions.
I believe I have been misinformed about the purpose of this vid.
Now then, O wise Prothean Elder, what wisdom of the ages can you share with us?
Solarian kidney is best served at room temperature. It is even better when the Solarian is still alive. The fear adds spice.
Protheon, no like you!
Did someone say Protheon? This one is familiar with enkindling. This one has enkindled multiple females across the galaxy.
Blasto, about time you showed up! The galaxy is under attack by Reapers! If only someone had warned us about them years ago!
This one tried. This one was ignored. This one's efforts fell on obstructed auto-
Actually, that was me. Sovereign, Saren, you might have heard of them.
Yes, and Blasto here destroyed half the Citadel, putting them down. But even he's just one Hanar.
And now we've asked Commander Shepard and his Prothean partner here to assist.
This one did not read that far into the script. This one does not share top billing.
Wait, what? But it's Blasto 7. Blasto goes to war? Think of the children.
In my cycle, your kind were nothing more than appetizers. Would you prefer to be boiled or fried?
Protheon, no like you!
This one has found his motivation. Very well. Commander Shepard and Prothean partner of undetermined ethnic origin, welcome to the Spectre Club.
You know what, Blasto? I think you're just a big, stupid jellyfish. How did you become a Spectre?
I am not just a Spectre. I am an Ultra Spectre Elite 7000 Deluxe, now with less recoil and faster load time.
Where is the airlock so I may throw you out of it?
We don't have a prop for that. Cue the sound effects. Change the backdrop.
triggered. And he's looking for some payback.
Cue the stunt double! Your line. Say your line. You die now! Oh no! The Fortune Counselor is indoctrinated!
This one is the hero of the Citadel. This one has an incendiary projectile with the Counselor's name on it.
This one is the hero of the Citadel. I'll handle it.
This one insists.
This one doesn't care.
This one wishes he was still frozen in a refrigerator. May we go now, Commander?
Strike the set! Telcasting will need a new Vorcha. Prepare for Blasto 8. Blasto cures the Genophage.
A good story.
I thought about it.
So who is strongest? You or the tank braid?
Yeah, I'm plenty curious myself.
What'd I miss?
The Prothean here wants to know who would win in a fight between me and Rex. You gotta admit, Shepard, it's a good question.
It is a good question.
No, it isn't. Baby Pyjack here wouldn't stand a chance. Don't listen to this fossil. The only thing he could defeat is a glass of warm milk. Ha! I got head lice bigger than you, Junior. We should leave these two lovebirds alone.
Let's not. I'd rather not buy new furniture.
In my cycle, too many people in one room risk a high casualty rate if attacked. We should all be careful. 50,000 years from now, no one will remember this party. What is the point? Beware. Something called a Kasumi is on the premises. It pretends to be invisible. Foolish primitive. Nothing escapes these eyes.
Trevor!
So here's where the party's at.
Goddamn right. Come to hang out with the popular kids, Shepard.
Easier to talk back here. What do you think of the music? Great? Bad? What? Not as good as in your cycle, eh, Javik? Am I right?
Not even remotely.
Knew it.
Oh, maybe we can leg wrestle later. Perfect end to a perfect evening.
Sure. Absolutely.
I'll look for you later then, maybe. I got a piss.
I told Liara that Protheans invented electricity. Asari would believe anything. I believe the Zaid human is really a Prothean in disguise. I like that one. He and I have discussed conquering the galaxy after the Reapers are gone. Though I do not understand why he's always damning his god. And one day, the Prothean Empire will rise again! And all the primitives will kneel before Javik! Protheans can read the smallest details of our environment. Tattooed human, I would like to touch you.
I'm not nearly drunk enough for that.
You then, shuttle pilot. How about you?
Why is Javik getting all touchy-feely?
Hey, collector-looking asshole. Maybe go touch yourself.
That does not happen until the end of the party. Commander!
Javik?
Apologies. I have been drinking the provided drinks.
Sure. You might want to tap the brakes a little. Everyone having a good time?
Will there be food available soon?
You're hungry, Edie?
No. However, my research suggests that serving intoxicants without nourishment is considered unwise.
I can eat.
In my cycle, we had food. Many of varieties.
You feeling okay?
I am Prothean. I never feel okay. So this drink is changing that.
Know what I could go for? Fish and chips. Greasy, salty, crispy, flaky, melt in your mouth.
Yes, that.
Let's get that.
Shall I arrange some fish and chips, Shepard?
Steve, is that your favorite?
Actually, I'm a dessert guy. My aunt used to make this chocolate lava bomb cake.
When I first escaped from Cerberus, I found these chocolate chip cookies at a store. Ripped through the whole damn thing.
Nothing in this cycle compares to the food of my people.
Maybe you should get cooking then, Javik.
Most of our ingredients are extinct. Except Krogan. Sari, Durian, Larian, and Corey. Is there any we could spare?
I hope you don't feel left out, Edie.
Do not worry. I've been employing a socialization protocol feature that came with this unit. It is called Smile and Nod.
Okay. I'll see about arranging more food then.
You know, forget food. This bar is impressive. Let's crack open this bad boy and see what we can come up with.
Beverages. More would be preferable. Nods.
Sure. Help yourself to the bar, but I'd steer clear of the creme de menthe if I were you.
Oh my god, you ain't kidding. That stuff will make you sicker than pure wrinkle. Whew, trust me. Shit, it is disgusting.
You're bluffing.
Don't be so sure. I got a pretty good poker face.
I can tell when someone is hiding something from me.
Right. Anyway, now we put our cards on the table.
It is foolish to reveal secrets to the enemy.
It's part of the game, and we're not enemies. Hey, you want me to deal you in on the next one? I bet you'd be good at this.
No.
See, that right there. Perfect poker face.
What are you talking about?
You're still doing it. Commander, can you believe Doc's never played poker?
How are the lessons going?
The Asari still refuses to take risks. Victory does not come without cost.
You're not even playing.
Doc's not much of a gambler.
Be glad we are not participating in one of the games from my cycle. You would all lose horribly.
Aw, be nice to Liara. You're going to have your hands full with me anyway.
Adios. How long have you been there?
Well, my willingness to gamble aside, this has been a wonderful evening, Shepard.
Glad you guys are having fun.
It's nice to see people relax and let their guards down. I'll try not to take advantage.
Time spent being idle? Do you fear the crew will grow soft, Commander?
I think everyone could use the break.
This from the Asari who buries herself in studying Protheans day and night.
Good to know bickering like an old married couple has not changed since your cycle.
Enjoy your game, guys. And I'd keep an eye on Liara if I were you.
Give me a few more rounds and you might not have anything left to wager.
Now this game is getting more interesting.
It turns out there is one thing primitives are good at.
Not a word.
Is it time to rule the galaxy now? Kneel before Javik. I had a dream. 50,000 years had passed. It was horrible. I was alone. Primitives had evolved. They ruled the galaxy. Solarians, Turians, the Asari. There was one, the Ara. She had those eyes and that voice. She was blue. No, it was just a dream. I smell primitives. It was no dream.
We will be through momentarily. Shepard, that console has not been fully scrubbed. It contains data you may find interesting.
What am I looking at?
Project Lazarus, your reconstruction.
It can't be done. It's not a matter of resources.
It's always a matter of resources. We're not losing Shepard.
Sir, Shepard is clinically brain dead. After that much trauma, that long with no oxygen, we cannot overcome nature.
Operative Lawson disagrees. She is now in charge of Project Lazarus.
I didn't realize it was that bad.
Interesting. It sounds as though your body experienced significant trauma.
Looks like.
How does it feel?
I'm still me. I doubt I'd have been able to turn against Cerberus otherwise. I don't remember anything. Maybe they really just fixed me. Or maybe I'm just a high-tech VI that thinks it's Commander's. But I don't know.
It does not matter. You are fighting. That is answer enough.
Tissue regeneration is proceeding. The helmet kept the brain intact, for whatever good that will do.
Lawson will find a way.
Sir, Shepard's an Alliance soldier. As far as she knows, we're a terrorist organization.
I'm not looking for a dance partner. We need Shepard, and Shepard needs resources. She'll work with us.
Impressive judge of character.
Every instinct I had told me not to trust Cerberus. But I needed their help, so I played along.
The past is irrelevant. Stopping him now is all that matters.
Project Lazarus is reporting neurological activity. They're requesting more funding.
Granted. Get me our potential recruits file. Shepard will be up soon. We need a crew.
Our existing forces should be more than sufficient.
No. We need sympathetic faces. I need Shepard invested. Tap Kelly Chambers and recruit Donnelly. I imagine Miss Daniels will follow. We'll want some old friends as well. Contact Dr. Chakwas and send me the psych profile on Shepard's pilot, along with a bottle of 47 Thessia Red.
Impressive manipulation techniques.
How's that door coming, Edie?
We are clear to proceed.
I am prepared for whatever lies ahead, Commander. The Reapers have haunted the galaxy long enough. It is time to end the nightmare. The last Prothean awaits your command. There was no final battle against the Reapers in my cycle. A great moment lies before you, Commander. Commander?
Was it this bad in your time?
Worse. I have been listening to the Krogan speak to his men. In our cycle, the races never came together. There was no rallying cry. I envy you.
Really? There's not much left out there.
The future is still out there. It is something my people could never say. There will be a tomorrow.
Only if we win today.
No one else has ever made it this far.
You came a long way, Javik. Further than anyone else here.
And I look forward to fulfilling my mission. But you are now the avatar of this cycle. The exemplar of victory. Not just for humanity, or Turians, or Protheans, but for all life. Every soul that has ever existed is watching this moment.
Well, no pressure when you put it that way.
Do not waver. Victory is never won without difficult choices.
I know. But I had to make a lot of those.
There may be more. But I know you will see this through for all of us, no matter the cost.
If we actually pull this off, what will you do afterwards?
Since my birth, life's only pursuit has been war. I look forward to seeing what peace looks like.
It's a big galaxy.
Perhaps I will write a book with the Asar... with Dr. Tassoni. She suggests... Journeys with the Prothean.
You'd do that?
I will need a job. There will be no Reapers left to kill. Thank you, Commander. For letting the last voice of the Protheans speak. It has been a privilege.
Let's go.
to get out of here.
This is where I belong.
Don't argue with me.
But I can still fight.
I need to know somebody's getting out of this alive.
Commander!
Good luck.